Much love to Audible for sponsoring this video and helping me trick people into thinking I actually read. Now, I'm not a judgmental guy. I'm a really judgmental guy. I mean, I get it. You shouldn't judge a book by its cover. Sometimes the cover literally says, I'm a weird person. Stay away. So, you know, maybe I'll just take that into consideration. Now, I don't know about y'all, but there are a lot of ways I feel people, like, gauge people. Some people peep how people dress and kind of gauge their personality like that. Like, if you like wearing crop tops and cut jeans in the summer, you probably really like Starbucks. Or just a white girl. Maybe you judge someone based off the type of phone that they have. Like how people who have iPhones are elitist and people who have Androids are normal. You know, stuff like that. Now, me personally, I found a very solid and interesting way to gauge what type of person someone is. And it's not based off looks. It's based off how they think other people look. It makes sense? Yeah, it doesn't. Okay, hold on. It's the title of the video. Da-da-da-da! What someone's type says about them. I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I feel like what someone's type is in a partner exactly says what kind of person they are. Like, kind of on the same level as, like, what type of music someone listens to says about them. And although that probably would also make a good video, I can make fun of you more by doing this, so we're gonna do this now. In fact, this is really just a remix of that love language video. For some reason, y'all like being told what you are, but it's a little weird. But I'm not here to judge. I literally can't. So today I'll be taking the types of partners people are into and judging you for like 10 minutes. Welcome to recycled content. Nah, I know what you're thinking. You're probably thinking, Kurt, how are you gonna make these judgment calls? Okay, this is really arbitrary. Like, is there a formula or something like that? And of course, very reasonable concern. That answer to that is no. This is literally being as arbitrary as hell based off my observational skills, which are very minimal. So, a grain of salt. I want to see y'all in my DMs mad because I said you were self-indulgent. Okay? Leave me alone. I'm just the guy. So, I'll be taking three types of people that people typically find attractive, engaging what it says about you for liking those personality types. That makes sense. I hope so, because I'm going to keep going anyways. Also, disclaimer, I'll be using my $25 patrons to represent the people I'll be talking about. That doesn't mean they actually act like this, necessarily. They're wonderful people. Join the Patreon. Patreon plug. Thank you. Anyways, so for the first type, this example is not the most usual archetype, but still, like, I feel like a pretty common one. Like, here, let's picture it like this, okay? You walk into a room and a guy and a girl walks past you, insulting you to get out of your way. And then you're kind of turned on. Yes, first up is the mean girl, not the movie or guy, or like the regular person. Maybe a little rough around the edges, but might have a soft side inside. A tsundere. For all my weebs out here, because I know y'all looked at the thumbnail. In fact, liking tsunderes, I feel like, is pretty common IRL, especially, and I know that because I do that. I am one of those. All right, the positives first, so no one sends me threatening letters. I'm gonna say you're probably a more ambitious person. I mean, this is going to be a challenge. The person you're interested in hates everyone. That's hot to you for some reason. So clearly you have high goals. You want to conquer your day and also this person's emotions. Also, I think something else to say is you're probably mentally tough. I feel like I don't have to explain why with that one. Someone can only take so much verbal abuse without busting, so you're probably good at that whole thing. And I'd say you probably also want control in your life. It might be structured. You're the type to plan out your day and whatnot, but are willing to lose it in a relationship. Anyway, that's enough making you feel good. You're kind of weird though. You are most definitely stubborn, else you wouldn't be dating a literal brick wall. So unstoppable force means immovable object. Also, you probably want to be stepped on. Actually, this is a positive, wrong category. But on one more positive, you probably do think highly of yourself. I think you have to. Or a complete masochist. Really, it's in either direction. So take that as you will. Next up, what if you like dating what is essentially a bull? No, I'm not talking about being attracted to non-living things. Although this is kind of interchangeable. A shy people or the dairies, because we're still appealing to weebs. We saw the thumbnail. And what's the difference? They both can hold objects. Both are quiet. Both can be multiple colors. Hello. Not much difference here. And just like someone who's dating a bull. Oh, that police are actually outside. Probably because I'm talking about wanting to f objects. And also, I guess, because I want to f object. Not like an actual, I like shy girls too. I also like this one. If you're into someone who's basically like a plant, it means you probably have the patience of someone who takes care of plants. You want to see people grow and grow with them. I see the big mom and dad energy. Not necessarily daddy energy, big difference. Not to mention, I get the vibe that these people are loyal as hell. Not just in relationships, but in general. I mean, if you like dating a bull, you naturally have some very nice features about yourself. Dating a bull means you probably gotta be really keen with your emotions. I mean, you gotta predict what a bull wants. Like, how do you do that? You
probably have really strong empathy.
And get easily affected by sad movies.
I'm gonna also throw this in the hat, you might also get moody.
I mean, you're into not having a lot go on. So your emotions might be super swayed either way.
Continuing with the negatives, I feel like you're probably really sensitive.
And that kind of translates into potentially being, okay, stick with me here. Vindictive. All that understanding emotion can be like repressed, I think.
And finally, with that high EQ, probably also might be a high IQ. Maybe this one might be a stretch because this is me and I am not that smart. One time I was looking for my glasses and I was holding them the whole time. So yeah,
they're really in their brain and are probably thinking like 3 or 4 steps ahead or overthinking. Regardless, a lot of brain going on there. And finally is the very typical dumb and hot.
But unlike the other two, I don't like this one.
I have a very keen thing on you must be smarter than me to date me. And that is not asking a lot. Actually, then maybe you are dumb. All right, hold on. Let me rethink. The time I talk about the positives and negatives will be a lot more different for this last one because, yeah.
I'm gonna say you're a very surface level person.
People say looks don't matter, but it's not the only thing that matters. But I don't think you got that memo.
You say they're also a little into themselves
and want control in their life.
It might be secretly manipulative.
So I can see you being in charge of things, low-key Karen energy, and naturally a bit of a narcissist.
However, I will say these type of people are probably the most ambitious yet,
or a little bit aggressive.
So they probably also look at the big picture and not necessarily the little details.
And finally for this group, I'm gonna say also nurturing.
I mean, you can be manipulative but want something to grow.
I mean, technically, if you're growing a plant, you manipulated it into getting bigger. It just has a really negative connotation to it.
Good manipulation. Good job.
And that is it.
Anyways, I hope you're happy with the things I've told you were very arbitrarily.
Now today, I read into a lot of people's insecurities. But I feel like the more preferable thing to be doing is reading by listening. Terrible transition, this video is sponsored by Audible.
No, generally Audible is actually a really good service.
And by supporting them, you support me with living. So please go check them out if you want to help out the channel, seriously.
And I mean, you're getting something really good out of it. Like, it's actually really good.
So if you're like me and lie and like to tell people you've read, now you can without actually doing it. Hello.
I mean, Audible gives you access to a library full of thousands of audiobook selections.
And some pretty notorious ones too.
Like, say you got offended by anything I said today. Might wanna think about trying The Subtle Art of Not Giving a F***.
That sounds rude, but it's actually a book.
And it's pretty damn good, I'm not gonna lie.
Me personally, I've been reading Can't Hurt Me by David Goggins, and it's like put my motivation levels up 1000%.
Mostly because I can listen to it and do other things, unlike regular reading, which is pretty low tiered right now in comparison.
Like, I'm too busy to read books. Wrong, that's over now. You can do that now, so.
And if sounding smart to your friends isn't convincing enough,
upon signing up for your, again, free trial, you get 1 free audiobook and 1 free Audible original. That's 2 free books.
So if you want to support the channel and get yourself that free trial, visit audible.com/KurtRitchie or text KurtRitchie to 500-500.
Like, come on, they let you text it. Like, guys.
So once again, visit audible.com/KurtRitchie or text KurtRitchie to 500-500 to start lying to your friends about how much you read today.
Oh, what's up, y'all? Oh, man. It's been quite a while, for kind of understandable reason. But before I get into that, yo, I hope you liked the video. And if you did, please check out some of my others. I have a lot of other things, especially the last video that kind of are similar, so y'all go check that out. Outside of that, yo, man, life. I'm living in New York now. I'm about to move, part of the reason why I haven't, you know, posted in a while. Plus, I started a new channel, Recreo. We talked about that last time.
That's really about it. I'll be back.
Changes are coming, slight. Oh yeah, and streaming's coming back, August 3rd. Hopefully, if I can get my Wi-Fi working in my new place. This is my new place, this is my friend Crystal and David's place. Anyway, I'll see y'all pretty soon, actually. Peace. Worst outro ever.